For this video, we test the impact of adding more IMG elements to our jQuery image crossfade project, and we analyze how the z-index stacking order works. A question is, if we add more images, will the code still work? Copy the lines in snippet 1. They go on line 21 of the HTML file after the last IMG tag. Refresh the page. Open the network inspector. You should see all 8 images are loaded. Repeat clicking the next button. Wait for each crossfade to complete, and you should be able to cycle through all 8 images continuously. The handoff of the active class among the IMG elements works as planned. When the next method does not find a new sibling IMG element, the length property is 0. So we start back at the top of the IMG elements in the fade-group container. The z-index property values we use are auto, 2, and 3. We use 3 for the fade-out IMG element. We set that at the start in the crossfade CSS file. All the other IMG elements are the default z-index value of auto. On line 17, we assign the next IMG element a z-index value of 2. When the fadeout completes, line 24 returns the faded out IMG element z-index to auto. Effectively, this returns it to a pool of IMG elements with an auto z-index value. And on line 28, we set the next IMG z-index value to 3. The pool of IMG elements with the z-index auto value are layered by the web browser under the IMG element with the value of 3. Thankfully, our code worked without any problems when we added more images, and we saw that only during the crossfade we needed to manipulate the z-index property. But before clicking the user button, we have been waiting for each crossfade to complete. So we will take a look at that problem in another video.